Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so we're about to get set for this second game on day one of the Fierce Four Rugby National Championships. This contest is between the Victoria Protec Thunder and the Japanese national side. Japan, of course, picking up the gold in last year's tournament. Nigel is in the middle as referee. Scotty Clouston-Julius. Sideline. About to start. John O'Farr, Nicholas Kunyak and Emma Stewart in commentary. As Daisuke Ikazaki gives a nice little pass away. Ikazaki battling pretty well there at the moment. He's trying to get away. Nice work away from Bomber. Picked up Ikazaki on the rebound. Tries to find a pass inbound. Oh, that's terrific work there for the number four in Haga. And Japan are on the board. Their first try coming in the opening 18 seconds of this contest. Bomber Lewis trying his best to get around Ikazaki. Nice little pass over the top. Tries to find Jaden Warne. Warne can't get past. And the opportunity there for Kano was too good. And he stopped Jaden Warne in his path. A difficult task to do because Jaden's normally a pretty quick mover on the court. So Jason Lees in the number seven jumper for Victoria Protec Thunder. Of course, his little baby girl Dakota, born just a couple of months ago, so he became a dad. Congratulations to him and Ellie. Nice work here infield to Kano. Ikazaki doing his best to come in. And Nick, we bring you in at this point. What do you make of Japan early days?
I like the way they play, the way they're moving forward, of course. Catching Victoria out on that occasion. Couldn't get the right pass away there. Kano, but got to say, enjoying the way that the Japanese side is playing in the early stages of this game. Let's see what they can do here on the attack as they get the pass back.
Kano, Ikazaki, now having possession of the ball, just taking his time. Some terrific work from Haga there in the four. In defence, Ikazaki straight up the middle. Haga now goes hard at the line and gets the points. And it was an effort there by the Victorians in vain, unfortunately, in defence, as now Jaden Warne. Hair's a little bit shorter in 2017, normally sporting a bit of a longer haircut. Pops the pass over the top. Bomber Lewis can't quite get to it. Ball goes in. Open court, and the ball will go out of bounds. How do you see the game so far, Em?
Yeah, fantastic. Nice matchup here. Lots of pressure on from both of the teams in defence, and good pressing in offence. Japan taking that first time out as Victoria was so tight on them.
So Ben Fawcett, just the player there in the jumper number eight, sporting that Ned Kelly-style beard. Nice work from Bomber Lewis just outside the key. Battles his way through. Terrific stuff, Matt Lewis for Victoria. Nice little pass over the top. And now Haga will have possession of the ball. Gives the ball nicely across court. And try and pick up Kano. And Tomoki Amai now had possession, and there's a player down for Japan. So,
referee calling that there just for safety measures.
So I got a little bit tense there early days, so it's good to see that Kano is back on two wheels. Bit of a battle going on here between Jaden Warne and Jason Lees, trying to pinpoint Ikazaki. It's a four-man attack here on Ikazaki. Lewis, Lees, Warne and Fawcett just battling their way through here. Ikazaki now doesn't even have the ball. So it's gone across court. Beautifully played there by the Japanese. They're just outside the key. Terrific work there from Haga. He's battling it. He's got some pressure there from Jaden Warne. Jaden tries to pinch it. There's a call from that far side. Oh, just out of reach, unfortunately. The pass from Ikazaki goes begging. And Kano couldn't quite get the connect. He was close to goal. And Nick, geez, it's a pretty frenetic pace at the moment, mate.
It is indeed. There's no question about it. As Victoria being pushed back. Japan's defence has been really good. like the way Japan are playing. Been a tight game so far, 2-1 with 5 minutes 55 remaining in the first quarter, but really like the way both sides are playing, but especially the intensity of the Japanese side.
So Scotty in referee today, he has possession of the ball. He hails from the beautiful city of Christchurch across the ditch. And he's a seasoned campaigner at this tournament. What are you shaking your head at, Nick?
No comment.
So the ball will be back in possession. You've got to know your sport, mate. You've got to know the people involved in the sport. It's not going to grow otherwise. So we get back
working
to play.
With intent.
Jaden Warne has possession of the ball. You know, just battling his way through. Gives it nicely to Bomber Lewis. Great protection there from Lees. Great work from Lewis, just battling his way across. Gets past Ikazake up on the halfway line. The power, the strength and the size. Bomber Lewis, take a bow. Terrific stuff. Victoria get themselves back and square. Two apiece with 5.5 to go before quarter time. Nice little pass over the top there from Hagar. Bounces once and Ikazake will take the try on that occasion. Daisuke Ikazaki, I think it's about his third year at this level. Now the pass will come inbound from Warne. Nicely to Bomber Lewis. Lewis trying to get his way around Ikazaki. Good protection from Fawcett and Lees. Terrific stuff from Bomber Lewis. Gives Jaden Warne some opportunity. Bit of space now. Great protection from Ben Fawcett. Now battling his way through. Jaden Warne over the pop pass. Couldn't quite find Bomber Lewis on that occasion. The pressure applied and unfortunately Japan come out on top with the ball and they'll have possession on that far corner. How do you see it going so far, Em? It's a pretty tight, intense one at the moment.
It sure is. Both the teams really tight in defence and heavy hits. There's a lot of strength on court.
Ikazaki now, nice little pass across field. That's terrific stuff. And it's Kano that finishes nicely. So now Jason Lees will start possession. Turns 40 in 2017, Jace. Nice little pass to Jaden Warne. Warne moves it beautifully. He was an Australian steeler in Rio. Hails from the Victorian rural town of Warragul. Plays the ball nicely, just in that front court section. Claim gold in Rio, and he'll claim a try on this occasion at the Nationals. 4-2 in favour of the Japanese, becomes 4-3. Haga gives it back to Daisuke Ikazaki. Ikazaki pops the pass over the top. There's a goal coming here for Japan, and a good one to Kano. Had plenty of space on that left flank, really opened up. And the points came quite easily. And now Jason Lees will get us inbound. Back to Warne, wearing that traditional headband, that Pat Cash-style headband, Nick. Gives the ball across court. Finds Bomber Lewis. Lewis battling his way through nicely. Good play there. Round Kano, round Hager. Now battling some traffic. Gives the ball to Jaden Warne. And Victoria get the points. Oh, what a game this is proving to be, Nick.
It is indeed. The way Victoria were able to score that try, making it 5-4 in this one. Japan here going to hold on to the ball and see what they can do with the possession here. They work it back.
Haga gives it to Ikazaki and they call a timeout. So an interesting contest so far. Take us through the timeout rules, Em. How is this involved in the game? When we take a look at the interchange rules and the timeout rules, how vital is it in this sport, Em?
Oh, absolutely imperative. They've got four on-court 30-second timeouts throughout the game that they can use, so they need to be smart as to when they use these. And they also have two 60-second timeouts throughout the game only, and they can sub on those timeouts. So sometimes that will be part of why they will call a timeout.
So Kano just getting the points on that occasion. Now we go back to the action. Nice little pass from Lees onto Lewis. Lewis, there's the familiar sound of attire.
blown tyre there for Matt, so we'll have a change of the tyre there. It's no good with a flat. Can't get very far. So Sarah playing the mechanic role for Victoria.
So we're back to the area there. So Sarah Ellis, the team manager, just playing her role on that particular occasion. Ball comes back courtside. And we've got Jason Lees on the charge. And he'll get the points on that occasion. So 6-4. Really tight and tense second game here on day one of the Nationals for 2017. And now it is Japan just on the key with Kano in possession of the ball, trying to find some possession. Gives the one bounce pass to Ikazaki. Ikazaki in some trouble now, finds some room. Jeez, he's powerful when he's got some size and some space. Oh, terrific stuff from Japan. Kano started it and he finishes it with the goal. Wonderful stuff from the Japanese. They proved themselves to be too good in 2016, claiming gold 59-58. An overtime thriller against the New South Wales Gladiators at the Netball Centre next door. Terrific final to call. And now Bomber Lewis on the charge for Victoria. He's battling his way through up the middle. Gets the points on that occasion. So 7 points to six with 3 minutes to go before quarter time. So it'll be Kano that gives the ball to Ikazaki. Ikazaki just trying his best to battle around a couple. Nice little pop over the pass. And it'll be the points coming the way of Japan. And it's Haga on that occasion that gets the try. Jaden Warne gives the pass to Lewis. Lewis battling midcourt. He's got Kano on his right. Now on his left. Now on his right. Lewis going beautifully inside that attacking key. Needs some support. Gets the pass to Jason Lees. Lees gives it back to Warne. Warne finds a gap on the right side. Scotty gives the goal. Terrific stuff from Victoria Protect Thunder, keeping the ball alive. Oh, how good is it, Nick?
They're playing some good football at the moment, aren't they, Victoria? A scoreline of 8-7, and Japan still lead. But very tight contest in this one. Japan now, we're going to try to find an exit hole. Good pass over the top here. Kano's got it now.
Kano now has the ball. Gives the ball across to Haga. Haga battling his way through. Goes into Lewis hard, but finds the way. And Ikazaki blocks the path beautifully. And the goal there to Haga. How do you rate the Japanese at the moment, Em? They're looking pretty strong. They lead it 9-7 with 2.5 to go.
Yeah, they're showing up. They're very strong here in both offense and defense. Really good to see Japan here for this tournament.
So Lewis will have possession of the ball and he's getting the goal there. So Haga now has the ball for the Japanese.
And we've got a back court there. So similar to basketball, a little bit different. But once you've crossed over the front, can't come back into the back of the court. So we've got a back court and change in possession now. Victoria with the ball.
So it'll be Team Canada taking on Vero New Zealand at 3 o'clock in Game 3 on Day 1. So a shorter schedule on Day 1, and then, of course, plenty of games over the next 3 days, culminating in that big final Saturday at the Netball Centre next door as Warne has the ball and possession, tries to find his way through, battles nicely, and it's jumper number 23 in Hitoshi Ogawa that tries to cause some problems as Lewis goes straight up the middle and finds the gap. And the points are there. So the pass goes inbound. And Shimakawa now has the ball. He gives it across court to the 55 in Sagano. So there's been a couple of changes. So 55 is Motoki Sagano. The number 13 is Shinichi Shimakawa. The number 24 is Shinuya Namamachi. And that's the Japanese side on court. So 23, Hitoshi Ogawa really playing a big role here. Ball's lost there. Shimakawa couldn't quite hold onto it. And now Lewis will get the points. So looking forward to the inclusion of Saya Noramatsu a little bit later in this game, hopefully, in this tournament. Plenty of size and plenty of power, and really battles well with Daisuke Ikazaki in the number 7 jumper. As the ball goes across field and Shinichi Shimakawa goes over halfway, goes bang into Jaden Warne, tries to find a way through. Ben Fawcett providing some protection there. Shimakawa bounces the ball to keep it alive. Goes backwards once, needs to find some space. Gives the ball across field. Now he's calling an equipment call. Wants to come up with something, trying to keep the ball alive. Jaden Warne on one side, Matt Lewis on another. Em, do you want to take us through that particular section of play? The ruling that Scotty's about to give us here. So, Nick, how do you see this game at the moment? Japan really on top, obviously. Well, they're behind on the scoreboard, but they're just looking strong. They're 11-9, Victoria in front by 2, but Japan seem to be coming back pretty fast.
They may be the powerful side, Japan, but you can see the way the Vics are playing at the moment. They're playing smart wheelchair rugby as opposed to what the Japanese side are. They're all ferocious for it, but they haven't seemed to be as good with the ball. It's a beautiful pass out, and they will go over to score. A great try at the end there too by Canada, Japan, I should say. It was in, let's see if I can get this right, Sagano.
Correct, Motoki Sagano in the 55. So we go back to Lees, onto Lewis. Bomber Lewis just playing his part so well in this Victorian side. Geez, he's a dominant force up front for Victoria. Battles his way through beautifully. Great work from Ben Fawcett there to prevent that block. Shimakawa couldn't quite get him, and the points are there. So now Japan will restart it.
We just had a big hit there from Japan onto Ben. Just blown his tyre, so we've got a change over here from Sarah from Victoria. So he can keep pushing up the floor.
They must go through a massive amount of tyres right across this competition. So Sarah Ellis, the technical advisor there, just helping out Ben Fawcett. And we're back with Motoki Sagano, who's at the key with the ball. Now pops the pass infield nicely to Ogawa. Ogawa back to Sagano. Nice little pass across field. Picked up beautifully on the sideline there was Namamachi. And Sagano will pick up the points. So Nakamachi did particularly well right close to that sideline. Now Lees gives the ball to Warne. Lewis is in a battle at the moment with Shimakawa going head-to-head, trying to find some gaps. Jaden Warne going up the left flank. He's got Lewis on the right-hand side, but he might not need him here, and doesn't. And the points there go to Jaden Warne for Victoria Protec Thunder. He was an Australian Steeler in 2016. His mates call him Jabs. And now we're back into play with Sagano, trying to find the pass. Gives it nicely across court to Nakamachi. Now it comes across field and goes out of bounds. So Jaden Warne has possession of the ball. Pops the pass over the top. Oh, Jason Lees all alone. Soaks up the clock. Great protection from Warne. He'll do his best to get there, Shimakawa, but can't quite on that occasion. Shimakawa, nice tap over the top. There's a goal coming here for Japan. Terrific stuff to Nakamachi. He's got some battles to do, but he'll go backwards. Gee, this Japan side, they're really giving it to the Victorians here, Nick. This is a great contest.
Well, it's still Victoria leading here by 14 points to 12, but as the siren goes for the quarter break, and the thing is, Victoria is still in front, and that's the big thing. Even though Japan, they've got the skills out there, that they're probably not utilising the way they should. Like, that was a perfect example before where Victoria nearly stole that, where Japan should have easily scored, but they tried to run down the clock. And yes, sometimes it is necessary, but on that occasion probably wasn't. They probably were better off just rolling through, get the point, and then get back and reset. And that's where you've got to be careful in those situations, because Victoria can sneak up on you and they can be a side to be wary about.
Okay, that's an interesting observation. I agree with it. And there's plenty of talent right across this Victorian ProTec Thunder side. AV, Antonio Vecchio, looking forward to him taking the court. And of course, the man that celebrated his birthday yesterday, Naz Adem. He was an Australian Steeler in Rio in 2016. He claimed gold when the Australians beat the United States in a thrilling double overtime final, 59-58 in Rio de Janeiro at the 2016 Paralympic Games. Wonderful performance from the Australian side. They really went through the tournament with such class. And they played the Canadians a couple of nights ago in Mount Druitt. And the Canadians went down twice, 73-53 and 71-62. So that was Monday night in Mount Druitt, the Australians and the Canadians. And the Canadians will take the court, making their debut here at the Sydney Nationals in the next game against the Vero New Zealand. And New Zealand, they've got some real class across their side. Plenty of size and plenty of talent right across the team, and I'm looking forward to the Kiwis taking the court. That's at 3 o'clock. I know that's a game that you're eyeing off, Nick. There's one to watch.
It will be indeed, but the way this game is going between these two sides, who knows how this will develop between Victoria and Japan. A scoreline of 14-12, it is Victoria leading. But as I said, this will be keenly second quarter to see what Japan can do here from behind the scoreboard. Though, Victoria, if they can just get their rhythm in the early stages, it could be their game for the taking. As the quarter starts, and let's see what they can do here. As the ball is with Lewis, and Lewis going down this right channel. Wants to cut across back on the inside here, beats the defender nicely. Keeps on going here, Lewis. Lewis will stroll over and will score the first points of the second quarter. Good stuff there by Victoria, and it will be now Japan to restart things here. May now going back to the right. And again, this is where Japan trying to roll forward down the left-hand side. This is in Kazai, who gets a lovely pass on, and going over to score here will be in Shimakawa. And a great effort there by Japan to hit back on the scoreboard. It is 15-13. Victoria lead Japan, 7 minutes 37 to go in this second quarter.
So Jason Lees will have possession, gives it nicely across to Warne. Warne pops the pass over the top to Lewis. Lewis battling around Ikazaki. Lewis goes the long Hail Mary pass. It bounces a couple of times. Jason Lees goes spinning. And Shimakawa battled with him late in that piece. And Jason Lees goes down and hard. So there'll be a change here. And so Jason Lees, one of the great players for Victoria over many years. Of course, he became a dad. Young Dakota, she turns 10 months old. And he, of course, celebrates birthday number 40 in 2017. So Victoria, they've performed well at this tournament, and I expect good things in 2017. They've got plenty of talent, especially with this 2017 side that they've got out on the court. As Shimakawa tries to get it away for Ikazaki, and now Ikazaki over the halfway line, nicely played, and just pushes it beautifully. And Daisuke Ikazaki gets the points, and it's 15-14 in favour of the Vics, with 7 to go before half time.
So we've just got an equipment here again for Jason Lees. Another blown tyre, it would appear. So the boys do go through many tyres throughout a game at times, particularly sometimes the low pointers, because they really get a sting when they get hit.
So Naz Adem on the bench warming up. Of course, he celebrated his birthday yesterday. and claimed gold in Rio in 2016. As we go back to live action, and Lewis goes straight up the middle. Shimakawa battling nicely. Ikazaki with the collision. Working nicely, Lewis. Just inside the key now. Needs some support. Good work over the top there from Fawcett. Plays it nicely, Lewis. Just trying to battle through. It'll be Ogawa close to the line. But the goal and the try is scored there to Victoria. And now 16-14. So their lead is now 2 points. The ball comes back to Shimakawa, who started things. And he goes up the right flank, flies over the pass, beautifully caught by Ikazaki. And they get the goal on that occasion. Terrific stuff from Japan.
So we've got a loose tyre here. Japan coming out of their mechanic to get that back on board. It's great defence from both teams. They really are giving it to one another. Lots of force. As you've seen, Jason Lee's not long ago hitting the floor. Back in play now.
So nicely played by Lewis. And he'll take it over the line and get the points there. So Lewis gets another goal for his bag of collection. No doubt that'll be pretty full come 4 days' time. As Ikazaki has possession of the ball, battling nicely around Jason Lee's. Plenty of space on that left flank. And goes over for the points. So great to have your attendance here at the Sydney Olympic Park Sports Centre. Coming up next, we've got a terrific game between Team Canada and the Kiwis. Stick around for that. And then, of course, following that is the GIO Gladiators taking on Victoria Protech Thunder. Nice work there from Lewis. Just battling his way through, and another point. Scotty puts the finger skywards, and it's 18-16 with six to go. Nick, how good is this game? So close, so tight.
Very tight between these two sides. Japan now trying to do something here on the attack, but it's been a great game to watch as they gain an overhead ball, and they found the target going over here over Shimakawa. Shimakawa scoring another fantastic try. The scoreline now of 17-18 here between these two sides. Victoria lead only narrowly. It's been a great game to watch. Let's see what Victoria can do on the attack.
So now Jaden Warne has possession. Tries to get around one and can't quite get it. Tried to get around Ikazaki on that occasion. Just couldn't quite get the combinations together.
So we've got a timeout here for Victoria, just an on-court. So they didn't lose that possession.
So now Jaden Warne will get possession here for Victoria in just a moment. Warne. Strong play over Victoria. It's Lewis. Now it goes over that halfway line. Plenty of space. Shimakawa couldn't quite get him on that occasion. And the points are scored. So now the ball comes back in field. Shimakawa battles into Jason Lees and has Warne behind him. Warne and Lee's trying to battle the ball. Ikazaki now has the ball, keeps it alive. Nice pass across court. Japan will float it nicely down that right flank. And the goal is scored on that occasion. Terrific stuff for the Japanese and Tomoki Amai. And now Lee's gives the ball across court to Lewis. Lewis battling through three traffic, gives it to Warne. Jaden Warne picks up the points. So 19-18 becomes 20-18. Just over five to go. Jeez, they're going hammer and tong here, Nick. This is a great contest.
They are. Let's see what Japan can do here. They've called the timeout. Interesting decision there for the timeout there. Ogawa calling it. So the scoreline, as you said before there, Jono, 20-18. Victoria lead. 5 minutes and 11 seconds left for this first half, of course, the second quarter between these two sides. And been interesting to see how this game will develop. The way Victoria have been able to hold on, I know Japan have hooked like the better side in the game, but Victoria is still holding on to that lead. That's the key thing to look at as we approach the last 5 minutes of this second quarter. And I'll restart things here. Let's see what Norimatsu can do with the ball. He'll work it back to the left-hand side. So Japan now on the charge here. This will be in Shimakawa. Shimakawa got the long boy up, and that was a lovely pass forward, and going over here will be in Norimatsu, who started things off, and he'll end things there with another goal. So now it's a one-point margin. It is Victoria leading here. Because now they'll get the pass on to the right. Let's see what they can do here through Lewis. Lewis now going forward, wants to cut back towards his right side. Now Lewis going up the centre, over halfway. Now Lewis spins over, and he will beat the defender. He'll go wide, then he'll cut back in. So there's a play on the ground here for Japan. Scoreline of 21-19. It is Victoria leading. And Emma, it's been a very interesting last couple of minutes of this game. Tactically, it looks like Victoria have got the better of Japan at the moment.
Yeah, they seem to have it over them in that way. It's reflected somewhat in the score, but 2 points is really a mere nothing. There's really tight D from both the teams and some great offensive play as well. A few long balls, especially from Japan, with that advantage.
Ikazaki going up the centre, gets the pass on. They'll stroll over here. Good stuff at the end here by Shimakawa. And again, it's a one-point margin between Victoria and Japan. So let's see what they can do here. The Vicks on the right-hand side here. This is Warren. Warren going back towards the left side. Now he'll steam back to the centre, gets the pass on. Finds here Lewis. Lewis gets a pass back to Warren. Warren now, what can he do? He wants to throw the overhead pass, looking for the man at the end. Therefore, he makes his call. And the score remains here, 21-20, Victoria lead. And it will be Japan with possession once again. This timeout has been called. So a very interesting contest between these two sides. And Emma, what do you see Japan doing here? I know it's only a one-point margin, but what do you see them doing to get the lead again?
Yeah, well, they've just brought in a new player, so that helps diversify the team. Sometimes different matchups work better than others. So with that, we'll see how they then perform.
Kawashi, who's on the field at the moment, we'll see how she goes in this contest. So it is Victoria with it. And this is Lewis. Lewis now, what can he do? Gets the pass on. Going forward here to go and try to get the ball, but couldn't at the end. Was in Lee's.
He missed that one, hitting the cone first. Yeah. So no try there to Victoria. And it'll be Japan's ball from the side.
The defence there by Japan were on song on that occasion. So restarting things would be Norimatsu. Now long pass here. Can they get onto the ball? Yes, they can. And they'll go over. Fantastic stuff there by Shimakawa, I should say. So it's 21-21, Victoria and Japan here in this contest. Up next, Canada and New Zealand. And it's going to be a fantastic contest in that one. But back here, we've got a good game here. Now with possession, he's in the Lees. Lees gets the pass on to Lewis. Lewis now trying to beat his defender, does nicely. Lewis now goes over halfway. He's going to bounce the ball. He's going to go towards the line and another try. So, Jono, this is interesting. Victoria 22 and Japan 21. Great contest. 3 minutes 45 remain.
Oh, this is a fantastic battle here. Japan really taking it to Victoria as the intercept occurs and Jaden Warren gets the points. So that gives them the two-point buffer. That could be vital. So Kaya Kurahashi in the jumper number 3. She is on for Japan. So great to see the female component in the game. There's been a great number of females that have performed wonderfully at the senior level. Robin Lambert, of course. We go back to the Aster on Western Enforcers. She was the original queen of wheelchair sports. And then, of course, we've got some great names in the Canadian side, which is coming up. Kristen Cameron, a great talent for the Canadian side. She'll be playing next. Her uncle is the former coach of the Ottawa Senators and now assistant coach for the Calgary Flames in the NHL. As they battle nicely through Shimakawa, and Japan will get the try. So great to see the female component. And then, of course, Maya Amai. She'll be representing New Zealand. So a relation to Benji Marshall.
Not wrong there. Is we'll have
tyre change for Ikazaki.
A tyre change. You can hear it from here where it just deflated. Made a big noise as we can hear, Emma, and that's one of the things when you're courtside, you can hear all those noises and where both sides communicating to each other. It's quite interesting. Not colourful yet, but it will be by day four.
Absolutely. Both of these teams really showing up today. We're only 1 point in the game here with 3 minutes left in the first half.
Warren found Lewis, and then Lewis now needs to spin back to the inside, beats the defender nicely. He'll work back towards his left side. He'll drift back to the right, bounces the ball now, looks at the clock now. Wants to spin back into the centre, trying to find that gap that could be open here. They might have to go down this left side. He's got Warren on the right. Lewis will keep on going here. Lewis spins around. Wants to get the pass away. He's been pressured. Gets the pass on the Warren. And Warren will go over. So good stuff there by Victoria. So the score here, 24-22. 2:48 remaining. So it will be Japan with possession once again here, Jono. And that was a good little play there by Victoria.
Yeah, terrific stuff. Just using their combinations well on that occasion as the ball tried to go back in field, and Jaden Warren on that particular occasion couldn't quite get control of the ball. So we'll go to the corner of the court and it'll be Noramatsu who has possession of the ball. He gives it to Ikazaki. Good work to Shimakawa now. Shimakawa battling through some traffic. Noramatsu doing brilliantly in defence. Shinichi Shimakawa will just be a little too quick for Jaden Warren. And the try is scored there on that occasion. So great battle here. Just the 1 point, the margin, 24-23 with just over 2.5 to go. As Lees now has possession of the ball, tries to get the ball across court, finds Jaden Warren now. Warren has Shimakawa in his sights. But it's great work from Lees that prevents any more progression. Warren now trying to do his best, just trying off that pace. And the ball will come loose, so there'll be a timeout called. So, Em, how vital would a timeout be at this point of the game?
Yeah, absolutely. Victoria taking advantage with those few minutes left in this first half to keep possession of the ball, because Japan's defence was really great through that play there. So Victoria's ball from the side now.
So it'll be Warren that restarts things, goes back to Lewis. Lewis now on this left side. We'll go over halfway now. Beats off the defender nicely, goes straight through to score. Great work also there. Lees moving on to block the defender out. So Victoria now get the score to 25-23, 2:14 remaining. As now, let's see what they can do with possession here. This is vital for Ikazaki to get a long ball out. He does. And going over to score, another try here will be in Shimakawa. That's the linking effort between those two this afternoon. It's worked quite nicely as Victoria have the ball back here. Let's see what the Victorian side can do. Pass out there towards Lewis. Now Lewis will be on this right channel here. Wants to drift back. He goes back to the centre. Now he tries to beat Shimakawa. On the right, he'll strong through to score. And another great effort by Victoria. Lewis is in. Makes the score 26-24. A minute 53 remains. As now they've got the ball on the left here, Shimakawa. Shimakawa going forward. Shimakawa now going to the right, gets the pass on. Oh, this is fantastic work. Ikazaki, who goes over. This time, the roles reverse a little bit, Jono. Ikazaki's the one that scored the try.
Yeah, this is terrific stuff about Japan. The versatility is amazing right across their court. They can really provide strength in attack and defence. As Lewis tries to get the ball to Lees, can't quite get it, but it's great work from Jaden Warren on that occasion to control the ball. Jason Lees did particularly well to get that pass away to Warren. Warren's battling through the middle. Kurahashi trying her best to get there, but it's Bomber Lewis that gets the try on that occasion. Kaya Kurahashi, the jumper number three, so it's 27-25 with just over a minute to play in this second period of this contest. Good little pass over the top. Nice work here. It'll be Shimakawa that's trying to go for the try, but Jaden Warren says, hang on a minute, I've got other plans. Shimakawa Here comes Ben Fawcett, but gives the ball to Ikazaki. Ikazaki should score from here, but the cavalry is coming. Fortunately, just a bit too late. And the goal is there to Daisuke Ikazaki for Japan. So we go down by one, 27-26. We're in the final minute of this first half. Victoria and Japan, we hope you're enjoying this contest. Day one of the 2017 Fierce Four Wheelchair Rugby Championships. Good work from Bomber Lewis, doing his best in some heavy traffic. Jaden Warren, the protection was brilliant. Lewis now starting to build some momentum. Oh, that's brilliant from Matt Lewis. Take a bow, Bomber. That is fantastic stuff. Another try to him. 28-26, 30 seconds to go before half time. Ikazaki goes downtown, tries to find Shimakawa. Shimakawa goes banging to Lewis, finds Ikazaki. Ikazaki now in some heavy traffic, got some Norimatsu. Norimatsu just battling outside, but now it's gone to Shimakawa. Shimakawa now, Kurahashi doing brilliantly in defence. Shimakawa, count is clocking down, 7 seconds on the clock. Shimakawa's running out of time, needs to get the pass, finds Ikazaki somehow, some way gets the goal. Oh, tell me I just didn't see that. That's incredible stuff from Japan.
Well, Chaya, all I can say is they like to do things the hard way, because it was, I thought the opportunity earlier on the score on that passage wasn't the case. And also one of the things I'm noticing with this Japanese side, Emma, and they're looking at the clock, and usually you get told, don't look at the clock, just keep your eyes and focus on the play. But they keep on looking to see how much time's left, and it might be a tactical move, but still, it's not working, really. You've just got to go for the points.
Yeah, well, that was a great execution there at the end, though. They've just made it on time, which you just sometimes don't see. It's really good use there of the time of the game. So great to see. The score coming into the second half, Japan 27, Victoria 28. So only 1 point in this game.
Half time, we'll take a break. On the other side, the final two quarters between Victoria Protec Thunder and the Japanese national side. All right, welcome back. Sydney Olympic Park Sports Centre. Goodness gracious me, that's loud. Okay,
and I'm Jeff. You took
it at you? Well, probably a bit of both. So we're back into this game between Victoria Protec Thunder and the Japanese as Ikazaki just slows down the clock. Shimakawa now has possession of the ball. He's trying to battle his way through now. Gets around Lewis. Shimakawa trying to find the gap. Now looking for support. Fires the Hail Mary pass. Too far, too long. Couldn't find Ikazaki on that occasion. So it's 29-27 between Victoria and Japan. It's the Vicks by two. We're in the third term here. It's been a fantastic contest so far as Bomber Lewis on the charge goes forward. He's a Melbourne-born boy. And his size always causes issues for opposition teams. It's Japan now. Shimakawa trying his way to get through. He has possession of the ball. Gives it infield. Now Hagar gives it infield. Goes up towards halfway. Nice little pass over the top. Ikazaki has possession. And that will be a goal in a matter of moments. And there it is. So Daisuke Ikazaki scoring the points. Kaya Kurahashi on the court in jumper number three. As we've got Victoria Protec Thunder. Nice little pass over the top. Bomber Lewis. Great lead-up work there early on. Lewis battling his way through. Nice pass over the top. Victoria on the charge. Gives the ball across court. Lewis still going for the line. And Lewis gets the points. Terrific stuff there from Harrow. Andrew Harrison in the lead-up work in the number five jumper. And now Kurahashi gives the ball to Hagar. Hagar goes to Daisuke Ikazaki. Oh, easy as you like. And the goal is there to Shimakawa. So back and forth contest, Nick, here at the moment.
Well, that's what we're expecting between both sides. There's an overhead ball finding Lewis. Lewis now cuts on the inside. Lewis is in. That was a great effort there by Victoria. So 31-29, 6:42 remains in the third quarter. Stay cool. And there's a big challenge at the end and on the deck on that occasion, Shimakawa. As they call it, of course, the premiership quarter, the third quarter. I know, using that line a little bit too early in the competition, still had to use it.
No, you are right. It is the premiership quarter, according to Lee Matthews, the former Hawthorn and Brisbane Lions coach.
So we've just had a spinning foul call. So over into the box for our Victorian player.
Hate to pick up John Owen's mistake there, but he never actually coached Hawthorn. He coached Collingwood.
No, you are correct. To their first title in 1990, but he played for the Hawks in the 80s. But hey, that's okay. Play on. Shimakawa gives the ball. Never take me on in a battle of stats. Gives the ball across field to Ikazaki. Now has the ball. And he'll just play it nicely inside that key. Although that rugby league night coming up in a couple of weeks, I expect you to dominate, Nicholas.
Yeah.
So, great trivia night coming up, but Ikazaki has the ball and he will play it nicely. So gives them a nice little buffer here, Victoria, and it's 31-29. We're midway through this third period, so it's been a great contest so far between these two sides, Victoria and Japan, as Harrow looks for some options, finds Bomber. Lewis now battling his way through court. Has Harrison just on his left-hand side, tries to get the pass away but might not need it. There's a plea, there's a call. And how did you see it, Emma? Take us through it. So we've got a player down. So Bryce Allman, the player that's gone down. Emma, how did you see it, that particular play there? There's Nazadem, he's on the court as well. So he celebrated his birthday yesterday. Happy birthday to Naz. As Ikazaki goes through the line. So now we have Allman. Gives it across to Harrison. Allman and Harrison. Sounds like a band from the 70s, Nick.
No.
Away goes Harrison. Pops the pass over the top. Finds Lewis. Lewis now battling nicely. Past Shimakawa. And Lewis gets the points. And Scotty will get us back underway through Hagar. And Hagar has the ball. Gives the ball across court to Shimakawa. Shimakawa over halfway line. Tries to find some possession. Now gives it to Daisuke Ikazaki. And Ikazaki now, he will have the possession of the ball. So Allman, born in 1976, which makes him 41 in 2017. He gives the ball across to Bomber Lewis. And Lewis gets the points. So Hager will have possession of the ball. He'll give the ball nicely to Ikazaki. Ikazaki just playing it through the midcourt. Has Kurahashi on the right-hand side, but will go deeper and give the ball to Shimakawa, who will get the points on that particular occasion. So this is game two, if you're just joining us here on day one of the 2017 Fierce Four Rugby Nationals, all thanks to GIO, Wheelchair Sports New South Wales, Disability Sports Australia and ISC. We thank the Defence Force for all their support as well right across the 4 days. It's wonderful to call a game, Nick, on the HMAS Canberra 3 years ago.
That would have been cool.
A wonderful exhibition of the sport. A big thank you to the Australian Navy for playing a big role in that. It was out there at Woolloomooloo on board the HMAS Canberra.
It was an incredible event, that was for sure. And great to see that we've got the support of the military here today and through this tournament as well.
So the pass comes back in field to Ikazaki. Ikazaki, Kurahashi doing her best to stop possession. But Ikazaki now trying to take on Bomber Lewis, finds the pass over the top and gives the ball to Shimakawa. Shimakawa now has possession. He debuted for Japan back in 2001. He's been at two Paralympic Games in Athens and Beijing in 04 and 08. And in 2001, when he made his debut, he was named as best rookie. So great performance from Shinichi Shimakawa so far in this tournament, but early days as Bomber Lewis battles his way through and he'll get the try on that particular occasion as the player has been knocked down. How do you see this game with 4:23 left in this third term, Nick?
Well, it's been very interesting, hasn't it, Jono? Really enjoying the way both sides have been playing this third quarter. The scoreline of 34-all. And hopefully we can see Japan get back in this game nicely. It's been good to see this contest go back to even Stevens. And as the timeout has been called for Japan, so we're going to time out here in the meantime. And Emma, I don't know what you're seeing in this game, but look, it's good to see that it is back to parity, 34-34. And Japan, do you think they can go on the roll in here, or do you think it still will be tight?
Yeah, we'll see. They certainly started this second half just taking it a bit slower. The intensity doesn't seem quite as fierce as that first half. So Japan perhaps wanting to aim for that more tactical way of play rather than the high intensity. Still some really big hits, especially from Bomber Matt Lewis, number one from Victoria. As we've seen, a few of the players falling down on court throughout this match.
Yeah, I think that's probably signified the intensity of the contest, Emma. You know, these two sides, it's, you know, a close one. We're all locked up at 34 apiece. Midway through this third term, it's a much different set of circumstances from what we saw in the opening contest between New South Wales and Queensland, which was a 20-point victory to New South Wales, 66-46. As Lewis now has possession for Victoria, and he'll try and battle his way around. Great work from Nazir Dem in defence there. Lewis just working his way around, 23 seconds on the clock. And Bryce Allman gets the points, the Australian representative of 2016. He'll give the ball across to Shimakawa now. Shimakawa from Hager goes up the middle. Great work from Harrison. Some bustle, and Shimakawa goes down.
And for, I think, the third or fourth time this afternoon too, being very hard in a contest, getting himself involved, and so it's good to see that you keep on pushing yourself to the nth degree. And what more collision calls in this game to the one we saw earlier before between New South Wales and Queensland? That was more of that high-scoring, free-flowing game. This one's more of that hard, bustle, tough game that we're seeing from both sides as well. Same restart here. Now he's got possession once again, Shimakawa. Makawa now will try to throw it over the top. He does find his target at the end, and he'll go over and will score Igazali. Well, actually, he'll still move around. He's trying to utilise the timepiece as he'll now stroll over on this occasion, and he'll make it 35 all with 3 minutes and 41 seconds remaining. And now Victoria will race back and will have possession here once again. So let's see what the Vicks can do here in this one. It'll be Harrison that will restart things. As what's the call here?
We've just had a contact before the whistle. So it's a contact warning. Each team gets one per half. So it's the first one that's been called for this game. Victoria with the ball through to Nas.
Waiter Andrew Harrison battling some possession, gives the ball across field. Can Lewis get there? He can. Great pace. Well positioned play for Bomber. And he gets the try on that occasion. So they go in front on that play, 36-35 with 3.5 to go. Kurahashi now has the possession of the ball. Gives it midcourt. And now Ikazaki. And Ikazaki goes in to score the points. And now Bryce Allman. He'll have the possession of the ball. Gives it to Andrew Harrison. Harrow tries to battle around Ikazaki. Does particularly well. Nazadem just battling, trying to keep the ball alive. He's gone down, Harrow, but Lewis will continue the play. Lewis smashes past Shimakawa. And the play will come back. So it's now 37-36 with just over 3 to play. Andrew Harrison, his collision rate in this particular game, Nick, it's a pretty high one.
He's been in the wars this afternoon so far, this contest. And now let's see what they can do here. Game Japan with possession. Ikazaki bounces it. Ikazaki goes over halfway. Tries to beat the defence, can't. Will bounce and will survey the options. Now move forward. Ikazaki now finds the hole to score. Will make it 37 all here with 2 minutes and 47 remaining. So again, Victoria will have possession here on their defensive edge. And now losing possession. Oh, great stuff at the end here by Ikazaki. He'll get the ball and score another try for Japan. So it'll be again 38-37. They get the lead once more here. And now Victoria are behind. So they whirl the ball forward here. This is Harrison. Harrison now wants to step off the inside. Got the pass on. Finds here Lewis. We did hear one of the tyres deflate. So time has been called here. Score remains 38-37 with 2:32 to go. As the replacement tyre goes out for Lewis. And he's had, I think, about 3 or 4 changes in this game alone. And there's been a few. And as I said before, this game has been one of those collision style ones. And it's been tough from both sides. As again, it will be Lewis who will have possession. Lewis will bounce the ball here. We'll now try to go down the middle. We'll beat the defender and we'll go over. So the score now is 38 all between Victoria and Japan. And Emma, very interesting contest. What can the Japanese side do here in this situation?
Yeah, the game seems to have picked up again in intensity in this second half of this third quarter. It's really great to see.
Ikazaki rolls over, and another try by him to make it 39-38. So now it's Japan that will be taking the lead in this one. So from where we were in the first half, where Victoria were the team that were taking the lead on those occasions, it's not the case now. Japan were able to get that lead back and a couple of goals as now they try to go forward here. That pass on, and again he's on the ground here, and the referee will call it. He's been in the walls this afternoon, as we said in this contest, Shimokawa, and also Allman for Victoria. And we're about to see the Japanese player come back out, or come back up. Said it's been the 4th or 5th time this afternoon. He has been very instrumental on this side for Japan. Now it'll be Victoria who have it. This is Lewis. Lewis now going down the middle. Fend off, he was pushed, and he goes to the right, got the pass out, and they will score. Fantastic stuff at the end there by Allman. And the score here is 39 apiece. Now it's Japan's turn to go forward.
So Haga now has possession. In fact, it's Kano. Kano gives the ball. Kurahashi tried to get possession now. Ikazaki. Ikazaki now pops the pass over the top. And
got a timeout there called smart play, as there was the 12 seconds running out in that back half. Number 13 from Japan.
So that 12 seconds on the shot clock, on the play clock. 39 apiece, 90 seconds to go before three-quarter time. And Kazuhiko Kano has the ball in field to Daisuke Ikazaki. Ikazaki just floating around the key, doing his best to get in there somehow. Kurahashi creating some sort of hole. There goes Shimakawa on the left flank. Daisuke Ikazaki pops the pass. Shimakawa's got himself in a beautiful position. And the points come for Japan. So Allman goes long, finds Lewis. Lewis battling through some traffic. Got Ikazaki and Kano. Now goes away. Great blocking from Bryce Allman. Terrific work from Bomber. Battles his way around Shimakawa. Great work from Harrow in defence. And the goal and the try is there for Victoria Protech Thunder. And another one for Matty Lewis. So 40 apiece with just over a minute before three-quarter time. What have Japan got in this final minute? Here goes Ikazaki. Nazadem tries to battle. Bomber Lewis somehow stays on two wheels. And Ikazaki goes through for the points. Great balance from Matt Lewis on that occasion, because the collision was quite fierce between Ikazaki and Lewis. As Allman now has possession, gives it to Nazadem. Adem now to Allman. Nice little pass, threading the needle beautifully. And Lewis will pick up the points on that occasion. Great team goal there to Victoria Protech Thunder. And that gives them a 41 apiece as we go 40 seconds short of three-quarter time. The players just battling for key positions early in that defensive 50. There'll be another tyre change to Shinichi Shimakawa. Shimakawa now will just change over that wheel. So that's all done. So we now go back to play. And it'll be Japan inbound onto Shimakawa. Now has possession on that flank. Tries to get around Lewis. Does well and tries to find Kano. Nice little pass over the top. Now has Ikazaki inbound. Ikazaki inside that attacking 50. Looking for an opportunity. Looking for something. Gives it to Shimakawa now. Shinichi Shimakawa battling with Allman. Goes around Lewis. Goes around Harrison. Shimakawa now left and right. And left and right again. Battling around Harrison. Good work from Kurahashi in defence. Shimakawa now pops the pass. Ikazaki. Terrific work, and we'll get the goal. So that gives them the narrow lead, 42-41. Have Victoria got one more before three-quarter time? Harrison has the ball. Clock goes down. Three-quarter time here, ladies and gentlemen, in this clash, this wonderful clash between Victoria Protech Thunder and the Japanese national side. It's Japan that lead it narrowly by one, 42-41. Back soon. So back underway in this final turn between Victoria and Japan. Jaden Warne looking left and right for an option. Finds Jason Lees now. Lees will battle his way around in the middle of the court. Needs some support. Gives it back to Warne for a moment. Warne gives the possession. Emma, you want to take us through that call there from the referee, Nigel?
Yeah, so they're in the front half and he's gone back into the second. So there's a backcourt. Japan with the ball now.
Ikazaki with the points on that occasion. Daisuke Ikazaki, so it gives them a narrow lead of 2 points with seven to go. Just over 7 minutes in this contest. John O'Farr, Nicholas Kunyak and Emma Stewart in commentary this afternoon here for the Wheelchair Rugby Championships, all thanks to GIO. As Lewis takes on the attack, battling his way through. Great blocking from Lees and Warne. Now Lewis still finding a way. Great stuff from Ben Fawcett close to the line as well in defence. And the play was picked out nicely. Ikazaki now has possession of the football. And now it goes to Hager. Hager gives the ball across. And it was well started by Shotu Watanabe. And Hager will finish it and get the points. So now 44-42, margin two. Lees gives it to Lewis. Lewis needs some support. Battling some traffic. Fawcett working his way around. Lewis just over the halfway line. Watanabe tries to get in there. Can't quite get his way through. Hager did pretty well in defence there. Ikazaki battling close to the line and Lewis gets the points. So 44-43. This is a thrilling contest, Nick. It's going back and forth and we've got ourselves an exciting final term.
We do indeed, and Japan have possession once again. He wants to know, he has it. He's able to get it away. Ikazaki, a nice pull, bounces over the top. Hager has it. Hager now wants to try to see if he can work it away. He had three Victorian defenders on him. And now let's see what they can do here. Now that Watanabe has it, he got it away, and going over the score here will be in Norimatsu. Norimatsu over the stripe. The score here is 45-43. It's Japan leading 6 minutes 34 remaining in this final term. As going forward, here's Lewis. Lewis, great stuff by him. And he's over. And now it's a 1 point margin between Japan and Victoria. So let's see what the Japanese can do now on return.
Nice little pass to Ikazaki. Short was Watanabe. And Ikazaki now getting past Lewis. Straight up the middle. He has Hager on his right-hand side, but he might not need him on this occasion, Ikazaki. He goes over and gets the points. So 45-44 becomes 46-44. That score change as Lees gives the ball into Warne. Warne trying to battle his way around. Gives the pass across now nicely to Lewis. Lewis just battling around Norimatsu. Gets past Hager and the points are there. So timeout, it looks as though being called out. Emma, take us through this ruling.
Yeah, so Japan's requested for that coach's timeout. So they'll make their way. It appears they might just be chewing some time, or they'll make their way to the bench. It appears they want a substitution here for Japan, so that's the need for the timeout. Otherwise, they have to wait till it goes out of bounds, so otherwise, with it being a try, it would not have been allowed.
So, Norimatsu calling for the ball. And he'll go to the key to get it. So Japan going all the way for gold last year against New South Wales in a thrilling overtime final. That was across the way in the netball centre. Terrific battle that was, 59-58. The bronze medal game went double overtime. And then we went overtime as well in the final. So two thrilling medal games last year. Suncorp Queensland Cyclones and New Zealand battled it out for bronze. And then the New South Wales Gladiators and Japan went at it for gold in 2016. Who will it be in 2017? We will find out come Friday and Saturday for the two gold medal games. As Shimakawa now just takes his time, soaks up some clock time. Smart play from the Japanese. And Shimakawa, he'll get the points on that occasion. Made his debut for Japan in 2001, so 16 years in the sport. Bit of a veteran, Shinichi Shimakawa, and he was a dominant player in 2016 from memory. As Warne has the ball and possession, tries to go over the top. Jaden Warne represented his country in the 2016 Paralympic Games. Nice work from Lewis, just battling his way through the key and gets the points on that occasion. So Victoria now, 47-45, becomes 47-46 with just over five to play. Thrilling last 5 minutes here, Nick.
It is indeed, Jono. And let's see what they can do now here, the Japanese. This is possession through Norimatsu, got the pass back. And now it's Shimakawa trying to go forward. And Victoria will win the indiscretion here.
Yeah, so Japan there, 12 seconds in the backcourt. Victoria now with the ball. We have 5 minutes left remaining in this game, and it's been such a tight game the whole way through, 1 or 2 points
So Lewis has it now. Lewis spins around here, wants to go down this right channel. Needs to work it back into Warne. Warne nearly had it, lost it, and was picked up by Victoria. Ball bounces away, and it will be Japan ball to score here. Still remains 47-46. 4 minutes and 52 seconds remaining here. They'll work it back into field of play. And now let's see what they can do. Ikazaki has it. Goes down this right side. Now moves across halfway. Works it over the top here. Good pick up nice at the end by Shimakawa. Shimakawa will score. So another try there for Japan. So the score now 48-46. 4 minutes 38 remaining here. Has now Warne, goes back down this left side, works it on here, where he finds here Lewis. Now Lewis going down this right side. Lewis, what can he do here? Keeps on going, beats the defender, and moves in for another score. And it was a great effort there by Victoria. Now the margin is still 1 point here, Jono.
Yeah, great battle here between Victoria and Japan as Shimakawa now battles his way through backcourt. Trying to find some cover. Good work from Ikazaki. Lees does his best to stop it. What a catch! Daisuke Ikazaki gets the points. Terrific play from Japan. And it is 49-47 in favour of Japan. Just over 4 minutes to play. So Kadir Faki, normally in this Victorian side, a big loss for them. The Fak attack was always a popular one here at the Wheelchair Sports Nationals, so it will be missed as Ikazaki now has possession for Japan, trying his way through. Goes over midcourt, past Lewis, great work from Norimatsu. And Ikazaki now doing his best, just slow down the clock and he'll get the points on that occasion. So that brings up 50 points for Japan, 50-48 with 3:48 to go in this game. Lees has possession of the ball. Nice little pass back in field to Fawcett. Now to Warne. Warne goes over to Lewis. So that goes through the complete four hands of the Victorian side. So a great team goal. Norimatsu now. What can they do, Japan? How can they respond? They lead it by just the one. Norimatsu. Now gives the ball to Ikazaki. Ikazaki just battling his way through backcourt. Norimatsu providing some brilliant defensive work. Up the middle goes Daisuke. And Ikazaki gets the try on that occasion. So the margin goes back to two. Just over 3.5 to go. And Emma, the intensity, it's certainly picking up deluxe here in this contest between Japan and Victoria.
Deluxe indeed. It's sure been intense, and there we go, another fall. Matt Lewis for the try there for Victoria.
What a contest this has been. This has been gripping. It's gone one way, then the other way, then back the other way, and you know it's got more twists and turns than a Hitchcock filler. And you're always going to use it at some stage. At the end, well, you know, you've got to use those lines occasionally.
I thought you were going to go a roller coaster.
Roller coaster? No, I'm not singing that song.
No, please don't.
What year did that song come out?
I don't know.
95, I think it was.
Probably.
Can hardly tell these blokes work together.
So we go back to the middle, and Ikazaki now has possession. So Shimakawa just taking his time outside the key. Battling it well around Fawcett. Good defensive work there from Lees. He tries to get possession. Nice pass to Ikazaki. And Ikazaki will go backwards and get the points. So the margin goes back to two with just under three to play as Lewis now has possession for Victoria. Great contest coming up between Team Canada and Vero New Zealand. Emma Stewart and myself, John O'Farrell, will take you through all the action of that contest. And then it's the Gladiators taking on Victoria, who are playing now in our final game on day one of the 2017 Wheelchair Sports Fierce Four Rugby Championships, all thanks to GIO and ISC, and great support as well from the military, the Defence Forces. We've had a great relationship with the military for a number of years as Shimakawa goes over the top and finds his way through to some more points. 53-50 on that occasion. So Lees now has the ball. Gives it in field. Good work there to Lewis. Lewis got some work to do around Noramatsu. Did particularly well on that occasion. Keeps the ball alive. Great work there from Fawcett in defence. And it'll be Bomber that gets some more points on the board. And we go back and we start. Em, this is a great game between Japan and Victoria.
Oh, incredible. And just great to see a low pointer then keeping himself upright from that hit there.
Ikazaki goes forward. 2 minutes remaining. Ikazaki now going back towards the left. Can he go back to the right? Gets over. So now it's again Japan who lead here by 3 points against Victoria. Could be their game for the taking. Warn down this right side. Now needs to move back towards the centre. We'll look down this right channel once again. Stops, gets the pass on. Nice stuff there by Lees. Found his supporting Lewis. Lewis now down the right. Lewis going himself. Spun off the defender. Bounces the ball. Then goes back to the right. Goes in. And now it's a 2-point margin.
So great work from Bomber Lewis. Noramatsu now in the key. Gives the ball in court. Finds Ikazaki. Ikazaki just trying to battle his way through. He's got Lewis just in front of him, but Ikazaki wins that one. Goes up over the attacking 50. We'll give the pass in field. And Shimakawa will get the points on that particular occasion. So Lees gives it into Lewis. Lewis battling his way through. Nice work there from Matt Lewis. Good pass into Lees. Lees waits, holds himself up just beautifully. Great pass to Jaden Warne. And Warne, the Australian representative, gets the points. Of course, he represented Australia at the 2016 Rio Olympics. He hails from the country Victorian town of Warrigal. 55-53 in favour of Japan with just over a minute to go in this contest. And there's an equipment change call here. Emma, take us through it.
Yeah, we've got two equipments here. Japan needing it for his tyre and now Victoria as well. Perhaps that big hit earlier that Ben managed to keep himself upright took a toll.
So Ben just getting that wheel changed as we speak. So we'll be back underway very shortly.
So it's Sarah doing a great job from Victoria. Team manager slash mechanic. Good to see the women getting involved.
Shimakawa now having the ball and possession, taking it over the halfway line. Matt Lewis tries to go at him, but can't get him because Ikazaki's in the way. Shimakawa's now got some problems because of Jaden Warne. Battles around Lewis. Shimakawa now needs support. This is great 2-on-1 attack from Warne and Lewis on Shimakawa. Now it goes back to Ikazaki. And Daisuke Ikazaki scores the points. 56-53, 44 seconds to go. Lewis, Victoria needs something big and they need it now. Lewis gets around Ikazaki, tries to go at Noramatsu, beats him, has Fawcett on his right-hand side. Now needs it on the left, but he'll go himself and he'll get the points.
Again, fast play there from Matt Lewis, which they really need to be able to get this one. 2 points in it.
Noramatsu.
56-54.
Shimakawa now has possession over the halfway line. Play it just nicely, counting down the clock with 20 seconds to go. Coming up next, Team Canada and Vero New Zealand to kick off at around 3 o'clock. That's game three on day one, the 2017 Wheelchair Rugby Nationals, all thanks to GIO here at the Sydney Olympic Park Sports Centre. As Shimakawa is just going for that line. He takes all the time in the world, 56-54. So 2 seconds left. It looks like it'll be a narrow win to the Japanese to open their account beautifully. Goes to Lewis. Siren is moments away. And there it is, full time here in this wonderful contest between Victoria Pro Tech Thunder and the Japanese. It is a win to Japan, 57-54. A terrific contest. That has been game two. We'll take a break, and on the other side, it will be the Canadians making their debut here at the Sydney competition as they take on Vero New Zealand as they find their first game here at the 2017 Wheelchair Rugby Fierce Four Nationals, all thanks to GIO. A break, and we'll be back with game three on day one.